नमस्कार एंड गुड आफ्टरनून. नमस्कार. थैंक यू. श्री कमलनाथ जी, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड टेक्नोलॉजी नागपुर, द डायरेक्टर डॉक्टर सुभजीत भट्टाचार्य, मिस्टर बकुलनाथ, वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट, the MLA from the local area, Mr. Sunil, Mrs. Munjal, Kedar, Mr. Kedar, Mrs. Munjal, distinguished guests, all the parents of the students who are graduating today, the students, and also my colleagues from HERO, and our partners of HERO in Nagpur who help us grow the company and service all of you with our motorcycles and scooters. My dear friend, Mr. Kamalnath had been asking me since a long time to come and visit Chindwara and this institute here in Nagpur. And I've been looking for a suitable time. Thanks to this invite, gave me a good reason to come and visit the institute, be with you all. So I happily accepted this offer. That's not the only reason. Young people have always fascinated me. I see this at my own home. Every new generation brings with it new ideas and innovations that bring change for the humankind. Therefore, as a nation, we should always listen to our young people, all of you, not just their ideas and feelings, but also to your aspirations. I may be repeating some of the stuff Mr. Nath has already spoken, because those are very important issues and very important comments. This is very true for a country such as India, where more than 50% of its population is below the age of 25 and more than 65% below the age of 35. It is expected that in the year 2020, the average age of an Indian will be 29 years compared to 37 of that in China and 48 for Japan. Now this actually is a big plus for many, many years to come for India. And you people are going to make the future of India, you people matter to the nation a lot. Friends, we are living in a highly fractured world. In the month of January, I was in Davos in Switzerland to attend the World Economic Forum, and so was my friend Mr. Kamalnath. The main theme of the deliberations at this year's forum was creating a shared future in a fractured world. To my mind, it was a very appropriate theme in the present context, and youngsters such as you all over the world need to ponder over subjects like this, because it impacts your future more than mine and Mr. Kamalnath's. The entire world is passing through turmoil, upheavals, and rapid change across the socio, political, and economic spectrum. Mr. Xi Jinping, arguably the world's most powerful man today, is changing China's constitution to be able to rule as president for as long as he chooses, thereby signaling China's transition from autocracy back to dictatorship. Some observers have rightly commented that with this, the West's 25-year bet on China has failed. Just when its own democracies are suffering from what they call a crisis of confidence. Political pundits in the United States are still wondering what went into the presidential election of 2016. And as you saw only 2 days back, the revolving door at the White House continues with the unceremonious exit of the Secretary of State, Rex Tillerson. On the other hand, Great Britain and the European Union are still confused how to manage the monster that they gave birth to, called Brexit. Amidst all this political drama, a battery maker by the name of Tesla continues to keep sending rockets into space in its relentless pursuit of research and exploration to create a habitable human settlement on Mars and other space entities sometime in the future. I'm sure you all know that he just sent the biggest rocket into space recently. Social network, Facebook, I'm sure most of you, if not all, are active members of it, is today the world's largest publisher. An internet search engine, Google, is today making the world's most innovative cars, so also Tesla. My young friends, have we tried to sit back and wonder what is happening in this world? Let me give you another obvious example. I am sure most of you may not even remember the ubiquitous Kali Pili taxi, which was plying the roads of all Indian cities and towns until recently. I'm sure your parents would remember. Today, we don't find the popular black and yellow taxi on the country's roads, but for maybe Calcutta, they still use those taxis. Why? Because all of you are using Uber these days. The world's largest taxi operator that doesn't own a single vehicle. I'm told that every day around 10 million people in more than 600 cities around 82 countries take an Uber. That is an amazing story for a company that was not even in existence just 10 years back. But Uber is not resting on its laurels. It is already experimenting with a robo-taxi, an autonomous vehicle, a car that drives itself. Uber's robo-taxi is already having trial runs around Pittsburgh and Phoenix in the United States. Waymo, Google's self-driving car unit that is now a separate company in the Alphabet family, is already operating autonomous minivans in Chandler, a suburb of Phoenix. I'm told it is planning to launch a commercial ride-hailing service later this year. General Motors, America's largest car maker, hopes to launch a robo-taxi service next year using cars that will not even have steering wheels or pedals. What is this world that we are living in today? Another thread of conversation at Davos this year was blockchain and cryptocurrencies. Some of the observers I met there are convinced that blockchain is the future of all transactions. However, I saw major disagreements amongst economists and government representatives of several countries on cryptocurrencies. Some were prepared to call it legal tender, but some were completely against it. Yet, cryptocurrency keeps rising in value. I am telling you all of this so that you know what you all are getting into as soon as you step out of this marquee. It is a world undergoing rapid change, and you need to take your pick. Do I take it as a challenging world, or I see this as an environment filled with opportunities? So friends, the real world outside this campus is going to be very demanding and challenging, that can make you lose sight of the larger picture. You will therefore need to be prepared mentally and physically to face the challenges to hold your own. Don't just be managers and try to manage and maintain the status quo, but be the agents of change and disruption. I have always believed that the choices that you make ultimately determine what you become, be it in your professional career or your personal life. In short, you write your own future and you choose your own path. However, to be able to do that, you need to be empowered to make those choices. There are millions of youngsters in India as well as all over the world who do not have the circumstantial wherewithal and the freedom to take their own decisions, to choose their own life. All of you are very fortunate to have been given the power to choose your own life. Therefore, as you embark on this promising journey of life, I urge you to pause for a little while and thank the God Almighty and your parents for giving you this opportunity and your teachers for guiding you and showing you the right path. For the same reasons, I also urge you to make those choices very carefully and with due diligence. Don't be afraid of failure. When you stumble, have the courage and motivation within you to stand up again and rise higher than before. But never stop learning. To continue to learn is the only way forward. Learning today is not restricted within the walls of this institute or the prescribed syllabus. You have access to everything under the sun, stored in the so-called cloud out there somewhere. I can clearly feel and relate to all this excitement and joy that all of you must be experiencing at this moment. It was only a few months ago in June of last year when I saw my own son graduating from Drexel University in Pennsylvania. This is one of the landmark moments and a milestone that is mostly going to define the rest of your career and your life. My very hearty congratulations to all the graduates. I wish you all the very best in whatever you choose to do. Devote time for yourselves. Take care of your health. Love and cherish your family. I also congratulate all the proud parents for bringing up such adorable young boys and girls, and to the entire faculty of IMT for their valuable teaching and guidance. Very well done. Finally, thank you once again, Mr. Kamal Nath, for giving me this opportunity to come here, be a part of this ceremony and spend some time at this lovely institute. Thank you very much and Jai Hind.